Good morning and welcome to this launch event being aired from the Mission Control Center located at SDSC SHAR, the spaceport of India. We are here to bring to you the live coverage of the launch of ASTROSAT, which is India's first dedicated multi-wavelength space observatory. The unique feature of ASTROSAT is that it will provide simultaneous multi-wavelength observations of various astronomical objects from a single satellite. ASTROSAT has been the much-awaited mission for ISRO and the scientific community. Today's flight is the 31st flight of PSLV and 10th in the PSLV XL configuration, that is the high-end version of PSLV. The mission is designated as PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT mission, and the launch is going to take place from the first launch pad in the next 30 minutes. In this mission, in addition to ASTROSAT, which is a primary satellite, there are 6 international customer satellites that will be carried as co-passengers. These customer satellites primary include Lapan A2, a microsatellite from Indonesia, NLS-14, a nanosatellite also called as EV-9 from Canada, and 4 Lemur nanosatellites from United States. This is the first time the satellites from US are being launched from India. A quick update on the orbit. Orbit for this mission is 650 km circular orbit with orbital inclination of around 6 degrees. And in terms of the satellite masses, ASTROSAT, which is the primary satellite, weighs around 15,513 kilograms. Lapan A2 is a microsatellite weighing 76 kilograms. NLS-14 weighing 14 kilograms, and 4 Lemur satellites totally weighing around 28 kilograms. The 50 hours countdown for the vehicle commenced day before yesterday. The vehicle is fully loaded with solid and liquid propellants and is presently going through the final phase of countdown operations. The countdown is at minus 32 minutes for the launch.
Namaste. ISRO ke Satish Dhawan Antriksh Kendra Sriharikota ke अभियान नियंत्रण केंद्र से मैं आलोक श्रीवास्तव अपने वैज्ञानिक साथी श्री राधा कृष्ण जी के साथ आप सभी देश विदेश के दर्शकों का हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं। हम इस समय आपको PSLV-C30 जो अपने साथ पहली भारतीय अंतरिक्ष वेधशाला को और अन्य 6 विदेशी उपग्रहों के प्रक्षेपण का आंखों देखा हाल प्रस्तुत कर रहे हैं। ये 6 विदेशी उपग्रह अमेरिका, कनाडा और इंडोनेशिया द्वारा निर्मित हैं। पहले ही प्रयास में चांद और मंगल पर पहुंचकर इतिहास रचने वाला भारत अब अंतरिक्ष में दूरदर्शी स्थापित कर विश्व के चुनिंदा देशों के विशिष्ट क्लब में शामिल होने के करीब है। देश की पहली अंतरिक्ष वेधशाला एस्ट्रोसैट का प्रक्षेपण आज सुबह 10 बजे संभावित है। इसके साथ ही अंतरिक्ष में वेधशाला स्थापित करने वाला भारत चौथा देश बन जाएगा। विश्व के केवल 3 ही देशों ने अभी तक अंतरिक्ष में वेधशाला स्थापित की है, अमेरिका और यूरोप के साझा प्रयास हबल दूरदर्शी के अलावा रूस ने स्पेक्टर आर और जापान ने सुजाकू दूरदर्शी अंतरिक्ष में स्थापित किए हैं। देश की पहली अंतरिक्ष वेधशाला एस्ट्रोसैट कई अर्थों में अमेरिकी अंतरिक्ष दूरदर्शी हबल का लघु संस्करण कहा जा सकता है। एक तरफ एस्ट्रोसैट के प्रकाशीय दर्पण का व्यास 30 सेंटीमीटर है जबकि हबल का 240 सेंटीमीटर है। एक बात जो इस उपग्रह के विकास और निर्माण से जुड़ी है वो है इसका अल्प लागत में तैयार हो जाना। सतीश धवन अंतरिक्ष केंद्र, जिसे श्रीहरिकोटा रेंज अर्थात शार के नाम से भी जाना जाता था, इसरो का अकेला ऐसा केंद्र है जहां से रॉकेट का प्रक्षेपण किया जाता है।
Today, many artificial satellites built in India are circling the Earth in various orbits. Through their services, they have improved the quality of our life and made it safer. But there is one Indian satellite that is different from these space-based assets of India, which is patiently waiting for its launch. Instead of using its vantage point in space to look down at the Earth, this satellite will focus its attention towards the heavens to help enhance our knowledge about the universe. This is ASTROSAT, India's first dedicated multi-wavelength orbiting astronomical laboratory.
In the country, there is definitely an atmosphere where more and more science students and studies are being encouraged in the country. Now, what happens is, so far, the scientific community needed to get the data from the satellites which have been launched by others. Whereas ASTROSAT is going to be one of our own indigenous satellites. And we are also going to provide on this particular satellite program a capability to the country where students and researchers can decide what particular celestial object they want to observe.
From time immemorial, humans have gazed at the night sky with wonder. Night sky observation was the beginning of human endeavor to understand the universe. India has a long tradition in astronomy. The famous ancient Indian astronomer Aryabhatta stated that the occurrence of day and night is due to Earth's spin motion about its own axis. Besides, he opined that shadows were responsible for eclipses. Later, the Bhaskaracharyas, Varahamihira and Brahmagupta made notable contributions to mathematics and astronomy. Much later, the Renaissance facilitated the detailed scientific explanation for the happenings in the sky. Different types of electromagnetic radiation help us understand different aspects of the universe. While infrared waves enlighten us about the dim stars, as well as star and planet formation, the ultraviolet rays provide information on very hot stars. Similarly, X-rays and gamma rays provide information on extremely violent events in the universe, like supernovae, or the devouring of starry material by a black hole. And microwaves help us understand the formation and evolution of the universe. Thus, it became essential for humans to launch instrumented platforms to outer space for a comprehensive observation of the universe in different regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Satellites carrying scientific instruments capable of studying those radiations behave like space observatories, facilitating the detailed understanding of the universe. After the dawn of the space age on October 4th, 1957, humans have launched many scientific satellites capable of studying different regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Those satellites have enormously enhanced our knowledge about the working of the universe.
The launching of the first Sputnik in 1957 from Russia, which started the actual space science exploration in a big way, was an important milestone in our exploration. Since then, of course, many, many satellites were made, and in the beginning, particularly, most of the satellites were meant for looking at the space and the space sciences.
India today is a prominent space-faring nation. The Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, has vast experience in building and launching a variety of satellites and utilizing them for many national developmental tasks. In the past four decades, many scientific spacecraft missions have been successfully conducted. In fact, the very first Indian satellite, Aryabhatta, was a scientific satellite. ASTROSAT is the next major space science endeavor of ISRO. ASTROSAT mission envisages an Earth-orbiting scientific satellite with payloads capable of simultaneously observing the universe in the visible, ultraviolet and X-ray regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Thus, ASTROSAT is a multi-wavelength space observatory of India. It is expected to further enhance our knowledge about many interesting processes in this universe.
You get a global recognition, because ultimately when you do good science, it receives global recognition. When you do a good satellite, it gets a good national recognition.
The cuboid-shaped ASTROSAT, covered with a golden-colored thermal blanket, weighs about 1,500 kilograms. Control system of the satellite acts like its electronic brain and provides the stability for the satellite to focus its attention towards a target of interest or to change its orientation. Fast-spinning reaction wheels or small rocket engines called thrusters actually perform this job based on the instructions from the control system. All these highly sophisticated equipment enable ASTROSAT to perform its astronomical observations flawlessly.
Though this is one of the satellites that was built, this has its own uniqueness. The uniqueness being the this is predominantly the science the satellite meant for the astronomy observations of multi wavelength. And as far as the engineering and construction point of view, it has given fairly good challenging opportunities for ISRO.
ASTROSAT is scheduled to be launched into a 650 kilometer orbit inclined at an angle of 6 degrees to the equator. The task of launching ASTROSAT to that orbit is entrusted to the Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, PSLV, the workhorse launch vehicle of ISRO. The XL version of the PSLV, which is chosen to launch ASTROSAT, weighs 320 tons at liftoff, and this mission is designated as PSLV-C30. This will be the 31st launch of the versatile PSLV. It takes about 23 minutes for PSLV-C30 to place ASTROSAT in its designated orbit. Along with ASTROSAT, six smaller satellites from Canada, Indonesia and the USA, together weighing 118 kilograms, are scheduled to be launched by PSLV-C30. Once it is separated from the fourth stage of PSLV, ASTROSAT begins its independent orbital life and after a few days will be ready to begin its assigned task of observing the universe in the visible, ultraviolet and X-ray regions of the electromagnetic spectrum.
These observations can be done for imaging, can be done for spectral studies, can be done for high time resolution studies. This makes us to understand the physical processes in the sources, different galactic sources, also their time varying behavior. So this is the basic objective of ASTROSAT.
The ultraviolet imaging telescope UVID is jointly developed by Indian Institute of Astrophysics at Bangalore and Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics at Pune in collaboration with the Canadian Space Agency. This instrument is capable of observing the sky in the visible, near ultraviolet and far ultraviolet regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Large Areas X-ray Proportional Counter, LAXPC, the second payload of ASTROSAT, is designed to study the variations in the emission of X-rays by a type of binary stars known as X-ray binaries, as well as to study other cosmic X-ray sources. It can make measurements of the spectral features of different classes of X-ray sources over a wide spectral range. LAXPC has nearly five times more effective area for collecting X-ray photons with energy beyond a certain range compared to another similar scientific satellite mission from abroad. Soft X-ray telescope SXT of ASTROSAT, developed by TIFR along with the Inter-University Centre for Astronomy and Astrophysics and University of Leicester, UK, is designed for studying the variations in the X-ray spectrum of a lower X-ray energy range emitted by distant celestial sources. This payload has a 2-meter focal length telescope with thin conical gold-coated aluminium foil mirrors. These special mirrors reflect X-rays that are incident on them at a very shallow angle. The focal plane camera of this instrument has a cooled charge-coupled device. Cadmium Zinc Telluride Imager CZTI, yet another ASTROSAT payload functioning in the X-ray region, extends the capability of the satellite to sense X-rays of high energy. This payload may also be able to detect gamma ray bursts and study their characteristics. CZTI payload is developed by TIFR in collaboration with Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics and ISRO. The fifth payload of ASTROSAT is the Scanning Sky Monitor, SSM, developed by ISRO Satellite Center at Bangalore, along with the Inter-University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics. This instrument is designed to scan the sky for long-term monitoring of bright X-ray sources. It is capable of detecting and locating objects that emit the bursts of X-rays during a very short period. Such extremely brief sources of X-rays will then be studied in detail by other instruments on ASTROSAT. ASTROSAT was realized with the participation of all the major astronomy institutions and some of the universities in India. It is the first satellite mission to be operated in India as a space observatory. Having patiently toiled to develop different sensitive scientific instruments of ASTROSAT to better understand the universe, Indian astronomers have a sense of satisfaction after their successful integration with the satellite under ultra-clean conditions. The satellite has completed its slow journey overland to its launch center at Sriharikota and is getting ready to take a rocket ride to space to begin its long-cherished look at the vast cosmos.
इस अंतरिक्ष वेधशाला के निर्माण से जुड़ी हुई ये फिल्म अभी आपने देखी, उससे जुड़ने के लिए हम आपका स्वागत करते हैं। अगर मौसम की बात की जाए तो पूरी तरह से प्रक्षेपण के अनुकूल प्रतीत हो रहा है। 24 सितंबर को प्रक्षेपण यान उपग्रह एवं भू केंद्र की तैयारी की समीक्षा के पश्चात प्रक्षेपण प्राधिकरण अनुमोदन बोर्ड की अनुमति दे दी गई थी। इसके बाद प्रक्षेपण के लिए लगभग 50 घंटों की उल्टी गिनती दो दिनों पूर्व अर्थात 26 सितंबर शनिवार को प्रातः 8 बजे शुरू कर दी गई थी। प्रक्षेपण लगभग कुछ ही क्षणों के बाद संभावित है। वैसे प्रमोचन समय अंतराल कुल 15 मिनट तक खुला हुआ। अभी तक संपन्न हुई विभिन्न गतिविधियों से वैज्ञानिकों के चेहरे पर आत्मविश्वास को साफ साफ देखा जा सकता है। हमें पूरी उम्मीद है कि ये प्रक्षेपण भी अपेक्षाओं और आकांक्षाओं पर खरा उतरेगा। ध्रुवीय प्रक्षेपण यान पीएसएलवी की ये 31वीं तथा संवर्धित या विस्तारित संस्करण पीएसएलवी की 11वीं उड़ान है। इसरो के इस प्रक्षेपण यान पीएसएलवी को जो लगभग 44.4 मीटर ऊंचा है, प्रथम प्रक्षेपण स्थल से भारतीय समय अनुसार आज सुबह 10 बजे प्रक्षेपित किया जाना है।
So we are going through the final phase of clearances by the mission executives.
All the range systems, the tracking systems, the instrumented systems, real-time systems, and range civil systems are ready for PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT mission launch.
Mission Director Roger.
In the next 40 seconds, we will have the authorization by the mission director. We just now heard the clearances given by the...
This is satellite director to mission director. Satellite is ready for PSLV 30 ASTROSAT mission launch.
Satellite director giving his authorization. Another 16 seconds before the mission director authorizes the launch, which will subsequently initiate the automatic launch sequence.
Stand by for the time mark. Mark means 15 minutes and counting.
This is Director.
based on the normal performance of PSLV-C30 vehicle systems, satellites, readiness of range systems, TTC systems, and lab clearance, mission director authorizes proceeding with the launch operation sequence and launch of PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT mission.
So mission director has just authorized the launch of PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT mission based on the readiness of the spacecraft, the ground station, the TTC stations. Now, at minus 14 minutes, we will have the initiation of the automatic launch sequence. The countdown is at minus 14 minutes, 17 seconds.
जी हाँ, टी माइनस 15 मिनट पर अभियान निदेशक ने प्रक्षेपण का अनुमति दे दी है और इस तरह से अब आगे की गतिविधियां पूर्ण नियोजित रूप से जारी रहेंगी. अनुमति की यह घोषणा प्रक्षेपण यान उपग्रह एवं भू केंद्र की विभिन्न प्रणालियों के पूर्ण अवलोकन के बाद ही की जाती है जो लगातार उड़ान के विभिन्न आंकड़ों पर नजर बनाए रखते हैं.
Vehicle director authorizes for initiating automatic launch sequence operations for PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT mission.
जी हाँ, ये वो घोषणा थी स्वचालित प्रक्षेपण अनुक्रम की जो अब से एक मिनट के बाद अर्थात टी माइनस 14 मिनट पर यान निदेशक के अनुमति के साथ ही शुरू हो जाएगी.
Minus 14 minutes, vehicle director has authorized the initiation of the automatic launch sequence. In fact, the actual automatic launch sequence get engaged at minus 12 minutes. So once we go through the automatic launch sequence, there will be sequence of operations with the vehicle through its onboard system will be checking out the performance and health parameters. So there is no manual intervention. It goes through the automatic launch sequence. So minus 13 minutes. If you look at the weather at the launch site, it has been very clear and very favorable. The important factor when it comes to weather is the one related to the wind speeds on ground as well as in flight, and of course any lightning activities that may prevail whenever there is an overcast conditions. But in fact, the ground wind speed has been very benign. The upper altitude winds are also too favorable, which means not much change from the earlier measured wind conditions. At launch pad, a very close monitoring of the wind and weather condition takes place from the start of the launch campaign, and the activities become very intense as we approach the launch day. Say automatic launch sequence is just about to be engaged. Another 24 seconds to go. This view of the mission control center.
Stand by for the time mark. Mark minus 12 minutes and counting.
So mission control center minus 12 minutes countdown.
केवल 12 मिनट शेष और अब ये छोटी सी लघु फिल्म जो यान के अलग अलग निर्माण के पश्चात आपस में समाकलन से जुड़ी हुई है हम आपके सामने प्रस्तुत कर रहे हैं.
So video documentary of the vehicle integration activity for the C-30 mission. As you are aware, the PSLV-C30 is a four-stage vehicle including solid and liquid stages. The first stage, which is the 139 tons of solid propellant, comprises of five segments. The first hardware, which is the core base shroud, is getting lowered on the launch pedestal in the first launch pad, and the various segments of the solid motor get stacked to make the S-139 stage. So what you are seeing now is the assembly of the first solid core stage, S-139. The stage is ready. This will be followed up by the assembly of the six solid strap-on, which are primarily the extended strap-ons, each having 12 tons of solid propellants.
जी हाँ, ये core जो है वो solid होती है, उसके चारों तरफ जैसा राधाकृष्ण बता रहे थे अभी, इसके चारों तरफ स्ट्रैप-ऑन्स बूस्टर लगे होते हैं और इनका ये पांच चरणों में बनी सॉलिड स्टेट जो कोर होती है उसके साथ समायोजन किया जाता है. ये द्वितीय चरण.
सेकेंड स्टेज विच इज अ लिक्विड स्टेज आफ्टर अंडरगोइंग द परफॉर्मेंस चेक्स एट द फैसिलिटी इज बीइंग ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द लॉन्च पैड फॉर इट्स इंटीग्रेशन टू द लॉन्च व्हीकल. Second stage of PSLV is a 40-ton liquid stage which uses earth-storable propellant, N204 and UH25. And after the first stage with six solid strap-ons are prepared, the integration of the second stage to the vehicle
10 minutes and counting
is taken place. So second stage is getting lowered into the interstage. And the third and fourth stage, which is basically the solid and liquid stage, goes as a single composite, as an integrated module. And the PS3 and PS4, as it is designated, what you are seeing on the screen is the PS3 and PS4 stage together is lifted and then assembled to the second stage of PSLV. So with this, all the four stages of the rocket have been fully integrated. This will be followed up by the activities related to the satellite.
जी हाँ, जो उपग्रह है उसके निर्माण के बाद उसको स्वच्छ का जो क्लीन रूम है उसमें लाया जाता है और उसके बाद सारी गतिविधियों को अंतिम अंजाम देके पुनः एक बार जैसे सौर पट्टिका है उसको डिप्लाय किया जाता है, प्रस्तरित किया जाता है और उसके पश्चात जब सारी प्रणालियाँ अनुमानित रूप से काम करने लगती हैं उसके बाद उसको वापस संयोजित कर दिया जाता है ताकि उपग्रह को यान के ऊपरी चरण यानी चौथे चरण के बाद में जोड़ा जा सके और यहाँ पे उपग्रह को एक तरह से पूरी तरह से तैयार करके यान के साथ जोड़ने के लिए स्थानांतरित किया जा रहा है।
So Astrosat, after going through the performance checks in the clean room facility, goes to the next phase of activity which involves the propellant filling. And right now, the satellite has been moved to the launch pad. You are seeing the co-passenger satellites being integrated. I think one thing I would like to just mention the viewers in this particular mission for the C-30 with the Astrosat, the scientific instrument, cleanliness of the environment, not only in the clean room facility, but also on the launch pad has been one of the very important factor and a lot of consideration was given to ensure. You can see the people wearing the clean room gowns. Other than the eyes, nothing was exposed. So in fact, the cleanliness was one of the major criteria for the performance of the scientific instrument, which was well honored and complied to during the all the activities related to the checkout as well as the integration to the vehicle.
MC confirms reception of SHAR 1 and SHAR 2 data.
बहुत महत्वपूर्ण होता है किसी वेधशाला को अंतरिक्ष में स्थापित करना तो उससे जुड़ी जितनी भी प्रणालियां हैं जितने भी प्रदाय भार होते हैं उन्हें बहुत ही हाई क्लास जो क्लीन रूम होता है उसमें संयोजित किया जाता है इसीलिए आपने देखा होगा कि जो भी आसपास वैज्ञानिक या अभियंता काम कर रहे थे वो पूरी तरह से इस बात का ध्यान रखते थे कि किसी तरह से उनकी जो जो निर्धारित रेंजेस हैं उन्हें क्रॉस ना किया जाए बहुत महत्वपूर्ण होता है इस तरह से रॉकेट को अपने प्रक्षेपण स्थल तक ले जाया जा चुका है आप अपने स्क्रीन पर सभी वैज्ञानिकों को बहुत गहन अध्ययन करते हुए आंकड़ों का देख पा रहे हैं आज प्रक्षेपण स्थल पर आसमान बिल्कुल साफ है विभिन्न प्राचल मापन के लिए कुछ दिनों पूर्व से ही गुब्बारों की विभिन्न ऊंचाइयों पर छोड़कर लगातार मौसम और हवा की गति पर नजर रखी जाती है और आज जमीन पर हवा की गति भी खासी सामान लगभग 10 से 12 मीटर प्रति घंटा वैसे लगभग 15 मीटर प्रति घंटे की रफ्तार से किसी भी तरह का कोई खतरा नहीं होता है वायुमंडल से पृथ्वी से कुछ ऊंचाई पर आज सुबह मापी गई वायु गति द्वारा कार्यक्रम को आवश्यकता अनुसार पुनः विकल्पित किया जाता है अगर जरूरत पड़ती है तब ताकि आरोहण के दौरान वायु गति की घर्षण भार को अल्पतम किया जा सके आज प्रातः किए गए विस्तृत अनुकरणों से प्रतीत होता है कि ये सभी मान अपेक्षाएं नियत सीमाओं के अंदर हैं सुबह के अवलोकनों के आधार पर वायुमंडलीय विद्युत क्षेत्र भी स्वीकार्य है प्रक्षेपण के लिए ये विद्युत क्षेत्र 1000 वोल्ट प्रति मीटर से कम होना चाहिए ताकि तड़ित की किसी भी संभावना को नकारा जा सके और ये संभावना बिल्कुल नहीं है वातावरण बिल्कुल अनुकूल
मार्क मैन 6 मिनट्स
another 6 minutes to go for launch view of the mission control center and just a quick update on the weather conditions as Mr. Alok was mentioning weather plays a very important role for launch of the for any launch vehicle during the atmospheric phase of flight so attempt has been always made to measure the winds as close to the launch as possible and use this wind conditions for biasing the steering program so that the vehicle travels is very smoothly through the atmospheric region which is very critical for any launch vehicle so as has been done in earlier launches several balloons have been released to take measurement of the upper winds view of the mission control center Dr. K. Kasturi Rangan and during the course of measurements of these winds the first balloon which was released at 2 hours 45 minutes from now
stand by for the time mark minus 5 minutes and counting
so minus 5 minutes for the launch
जी हाँ, अब हम प्रमोचन से केवल 5 मिनट की दूरी पर हैं और बहुत महत्वपूर्ण घड़ियां होती हैं ये। आप अपने स्क्रीन पर अंतरिक्ष कार्यक्रम एंट्रिक्स कार्यक्रम के डायरेक्टर को देख पा रहे थे और इस समय अभियान नियंत्रण केंद्र तथा प्रक्षेपण नियमित सभी विशेषज्ञ उड़ान संबंधित विभिन्न प्राचलों का बड़ी सूक्ष्मता से निरीक्षण करने में व्यस्त हैं। लगभग हम 620 से 630 गतिविधियों को अंजाम दे चुके हैं और शेष क्रियाकलाप कुछ ही क्षणों में एक पूर्व निर्धारित कार्यक्रम के तहत पूरे कर लिए जाएंगे। प्रक्षेपण के लिए लगभग 750 के आसपास गतिविधियां होती हैं। इस समय हम करीब 4 मिनट 10 सेकंड की दूरी पर
अराउंड 4 मिनट्स फॉर लॉन्च।
Mark means 4 minutes and counting.
So at T0, we will have the ignition of the solid core motor followed by the ignition of the 4 solid strap-ons, which enables the vehicle to lift off from the ground. And subsequently, 25 seconds into the flight, we will have the remaining 2 strap-ons of PSLV also getting ignited, which is called as the airlit strap-ons. So 3 minutes 40 seconds.
Aap apne screen par Shri Kunikrishnan ji ko dekh pa rahe hain, chairman. एलपीएससी के डायरेक्टर सभी को आपने अपनी स्क्रीन पर देखा। ये बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण घड़ियां होती हैं। इसमें जो 6 विदेशी उपग्रह हैं वो एंट्रिक्स कॉरपोरेशन, जो इसरो की ही एक वाणिज्यिक इकाई है, राष्ट्रीय व अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर प्रक्षेपण की किसी भी संभावना को तलाश कर उसे अंजाम तक पहुँचाने में महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाती है। इसके लिए विदेश की इन कंपनियों ने पिछले 7 सालों में इसरो के साथ कई करार किए हैं जिनकी परिणति आज आपके सामने है।
मार्क माइनस 3 मिनट्स एंड काउंटिंग।
3 मिनट की दूरी पर प्रक्षेपण से कितनी भी महारत हासिल हो, कितना भी कोई एक्सपर्ट हो, हर देश इन घड़ियों में बिल्कुल नेल बाइटिंग फिनिश जैसा, हर सांस रुकी हुई सी, 2 मिनट 2.5 मिनट की दूरी पर इस समय हम।
So 2 minutes 32 seconds.
Core का ignition, strap-on का प्रज्वलन और इसके साथ ही rocket का प्रक्षेपण, कितनी घड़ियां एक साथ संयोजित होती हैं, घटित होती हैं, तब एक प्रक्षेपण सफल होता है।
So automatic launch sequence is going through the final checkout operations.
Stand by for the time mark.
We are seeing on the screen in the mission
mark
control
center. Minus 2 minutes and counting.
Minus 2 minutes.
Phase 2 charging of PS2 EGC accumulator completed.
बिल्कुल अंतिम घड़ियां आपके सामने, बड़े गर्व से खड़ा PSLV C30 अपने पथ पर अग्रसर होने के लिए।
So 1 minute 30 seconds.
Mark means 1 minute 30 seconds.
So we'll wait for the final announcement of the countdown from the Mission Control Center.
अब जो भी उद्घोषणा आप सुनेंगे वो सीधे Mission Control Center की आवाज आपके कानों तक।
Stand by for the time mark. Mark minus 1 minute and counting. Minus 55 seconds.
Vehicles are armed.
Minus 50 seconds.
Sequencers armed.
Minus 45 seconds. Minus 40 seconds.
PS2 VHPP open.
Minus 35 seconds. Minus 30 seconds.
Real-time programs activated.
Roger. Minus 25 seconds.
PS2 VSPP open.
Minus 20 seconds.
PS1 ignition RMS arm.
15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 0 plus 1 plus 2,
PS1
plus 3, plus 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, plus 10 seconds.
V3 dragging, auto dragging, V2 dragging,
plus 15 seconds, plus 20 seconds. Plus 25 seconds.
Lift step bombs ignited.
Plus 30 seconds. Plus 35 seconds. Plus 40 seconds. Plus 45 seconds. Plus 50 seconds. Plus 55 seconds.
Six, plus 1 minute. Bonds and the core stage going through the atmosphere. Altitude of almost 22 kilometers has been reached. 67 seconds into the flight.
Bilkul saman prajalan tha. Charo strapon bilkul saman se prajalit huye. Aur unka nishpadan bilkul saman.
The four ground-lit strap-ons, which were ignited along with the solid core, have been successfully separated. Ye in the next another 10 to 20 seconds, we will have the separation of the air-lit strap-on, followed by the separation of the first stage. The ground-lit, air-lit, and first stage has been separated. Second stage has been ignited at 113.8 seconds. And the vehicle is at an altitude of 88 kilometers as per the pre-flight conditions, and it has crossed almost 125 kilometers of range from the launch base.
जी हाँ, प्रथम चरण अलग हो चुका था, पृथक्करण के बाद द्वितीय चरण प्रज्वलित हुआ बिल्कुल सामान्य रूप से, और उसका निष्पादन भी बिल्कुल अनुमानित आप देख पाते हैं अपने स्क्रीन पर जो ग्राफ है, उनमें अनुमानित और अवलोकित पथ बिल्कुल एक दूसरे को अनुसरण करते हुए आगे बढ़ते जा रहे हैं. बिल्कुल कॉपी बुक लॉन्च की तरह सामान्य निष्पादन. लगभग 170 सेकंड का समय व्यतीत हो चुका है. हीट शील्ड अलग हो चुकी है.
सो ड्यूरिंग द सेकंड स्टेज ऑफ फ्लाइट, वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट इवेंट इज द इनिशिएशन ऑफ द क्लोज लूप गाइडेंस, व्हिच हैपेंड एट 117 सेकंड्स एंड एट 170 सेकंड्स द हीट शील्ड, द पेलोड फायरिंग व्हिच प्रोटेक्ट्स द सैटेलाइट फ्रॉम ड्यूरिंग द एटमॉस्फेरिक रीजन ऑफ फ्लाइट हैज बीन सेपरेटेड एट एन ऑल्टीट्यूड ऑफ 115 kilometers. The performance of the vehicle, as you are seeing on your screen, the time, altitude and velocity and the ground race as per the pre-flight conditions. 200 seconds into the flight with 3.2 kilometer velocity. The PS2 separation nominally is expected at 262 seconds when the vehicle altitude is around 157 kilometers with a velocity of 5.2 kilometer per second. So we are 222 seconds into the flight.
जाता है इसका कुल प्रज्वलन काल जो है वो लगभग 151 सेकंड है. हम लोग बहुत ही करीब इस PS2 जो है वो पृथक्करण हो चुका है उसका द्वितीय चरण का, और तृतीय चरण जो है वो प्रज्वलित हो गया.
So second stage has been successfully separated at 262 seconds, which was immediately followed by the ignition of the solid third stage PS3 at 263 seconds. The vehicle is almost at an altitude of 160 kilometers with a velocity of 5 kilometers. So we will have PS3, which is the third stage of PSLV, burning for the next 100 seconds, after which there will be a long coasting before the fourth stage of the rocket is ignited. So that will last for almost 500 seconds plus. So maybe in the next 50 to 60 seconds, we will hear the announcement of PS3 burnout, followed by PS3 separation at a much later time.
जी हाँ, तृतीय चरण प्रमोचन के 264 सेकंड के बाद प्रज्वलित होता है, परंतु तृतीय चरण के पृथक्करण के समय यान 335.5 किलोमीटर की ऊंचाई तक जा पहुंचता है. तृतीय चरण पृथक्करण पर यान के वेग का मान लगभग 7.54 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड होता है. इस चरण का प्रज्वलन काल लगभग 324 सेकंड का होता है. दरअसल इस समय जो तृतीय चरण होता है वो प्रज्वलित होने के बाद एक क्षण आता है जब उसका बर्नआउट हो जाता है, और उसके बाद धीरे धीरे थ्रस्ट को कम होने दिया जाता है ताकि चौथे चरण के प्रज्वलन के बाद किसी तरह के संघर्ष की संभावना ना रहे. और इसे निशक्ति काल या कोस्टिंग पीरियड कहा जाता है। ये बहुत महत्वपूर्ण होता है और ये क्षण बहुत ही नज़दीक आपके सामने घटित होने को। इस समय हम लगभग 374 सेकंड का समय व्यतीत करके 7.19 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड की स्पीड प्राप्त कर चुके हैं।
383 सेकंड्स, 7.2 किलोमीटर पर सेकंड वेलोसिटी। जस्ट अवेटिंग द PS3 बर्न आउट, सो थर्ड स्टेज हैज बर्नड आउट एंड फ्रॉम दिस इवेंट ऑनवर्ड्स टिल द अपर स्टेज ऑफ द रॉकेट द PS4 व्हिच इज इग्नाइटेड will be nominally happening at an instant of 1017 seconds, which is I would say roughly around another 600 seconds along to go from now.
Yeah. Bilkul, bilkul, Akshan ji.
And this mission of PSLV-C30, it's an eastward mission, as you are seeing on your screen, the right side of the plot, which shows the ground trace as the vehicle has lifted off from SHAR going eastward. And this being a low inclination mission, nominally the inclination could be somewhere around 17 to 18 degrees, but the upper stage of the rocket will perform the yaw maneuver to make the inclination of the final orbit to a requirement of 6 degrees, which is essentially required for the ASTROSAT mission. And in fact, the co-passenger satellites which are flying this mission are also preferring to go into a mission which is almost an equatorial kind of orbit.
Combined coasting is normal.
बिल्कुल सामान्य निष्पादन की घोषणा। राधा कृष्ण जी, मैं अपने दर्शकों को बताना चाहूँगा कुछ एस्ट्रोसैट के विषय में जानकारी। बहुतरंग दर्द वाली देश की पहली अंतरिक्ष वेधशाला, जिसे खगोलीय अध्ययन के लिए भारतीय वैज्ञानिकों तथा शोधकर्ताओं को समर्पित किया जा रहा है, इससे आकाशीय पिंडों पर नज़र रखी जा सकेगी। इसमें लगे पदार्थ ब्रह्मांड के गठन वाले विभिन्न खगोलीय पिंडों में होने वाली खगोल भौतिकी प्रक्रियाओं के बारे में गहरी जानकारी मिलेगी। देश के वैज्ञानिक गहन अंतरिक्ष में आकाश में बृहस्पति और शनि ग्रह के अरोरा या प्रभा मंडल के ध्रुवीय प्रकाश का अध्ययन करेंगे। न्यूट्रॉन तारों और ब्लैक होल से युक्त बाइनरी स्टार सिस्टम पर चलने वाली उच्च ऊर्जा प्रक्रियाओं को समझना, न्यूट्रॉन तारे के चुंबकीय क्षेत्रों के बारे में अनुमान लगाना, हमारी आकाश गंगा से परे स्टार संसद में उच्च ऊर्जा प्रक्रियाओं और उन क्षेत्रों के विषय में अध्ययन करना जहाँ तारों का जन्म होता है, आकाश की चमकीली एक्स किरणों के स्रोतों के रहस्य का पता लगाना, पराबैंगनी क्षेत्र में ब्रह्मांड का सीमित एवं गहन फील्ड सर्वेक्षण तथा सक्रिय नाभिक वाली आकाश गंगाओं का अध्ययन, जाने कितनी ऐसी प्रक्रियाएं हैं जिनके जानकारी हासिल करना बहुत आवश्यक होता है, और ये पहली वेधशाला इन्हीं उपयोगों को समर्पित।
The time is 5:35 seconds, 7 kilometers. As I was mentioning, we have a long coasting between the third and fourth stage of the rocket. This coasting time has been arrived at based on the mission requirements. And as you may recall, the fourth stage of the rocket, which is the PS4 stage, nominally it has a propellant loading of 2.5 tons. But in this particular mission, because of the mission requirements, the upper stage has a stage which is having a loading of 1.6 tons. So 565 seconds, velocity is 7.1, altitude 324. Actually, in the during the coasting phase, if you look at it, as there is no propulsion activity that is being activated during this phase, the vehicle is just climbing the altitude. As a result, the velocity is going to come down. You can see in the subsequent phase of time, the altitude has been continuously increasing with a slight, and PS3 has been just separated at 587 seconds. And we will have the ignition of PS4 at 1017 seconds, which is another 600 seconds to go for the in the coming time.
Yeah, so I was telling you about the upgrade. After this, we will have the information. There are 5 pradayabhar or payload. The majority of the research is gahan antariksh ke wo X-ray jo kirane hoti hain, jo source se utsarjit hoti hain, shroton se, unka adhyan kiya jata hai. Ultraviolet imaging telescope जो है वो उसे इंडियन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एस्ट्रोफिजिक्स और इंटर्स यूनिवर्सिटी सेंटर फॉर एस्ट्रोनॉमी एंड एस्ट्रोफिजिक्स ने संयुक्त रूप से विकसित किया है। लार्ज एरिया एक्सरे, प्रोपोर्शनल काउंटर, लैक्स पीसी, ये विशिष्ट पदार्थभार 3 से लेकर 80 किलो इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट तक विभिन्न स्रोतों से प्राप्त एक्स किरणों का मापन करता है। इसे टाटा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फंडामेंटल रिसर्च TFIR और रमन रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट RRI ने किया है विकसित। सॉफ्ट एक्सरे टेलीस्कोप SXT को TIFR ने, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ लिस्टर UK और इसरो ने संयुक्त रूप से विकसित किया है। इसे भी एक्स किरणों के उत्सर्जन और मापन के लिए बनाया गया है। इसका जो रेंज है परास है वो 0.3 से 8 किलो इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट तक है। कैडमियम जिंक टेलोराइड इमेजर CZTI इसके द्वारा 10 से 100 किलो इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट तक की किरणों को मापन किया जा सकेगा। और अंतिम स्कैनिंग स्काई मॉनिटर SSSM जो इसरो और IUCSN मिलकर विकसित किया है, बहुत महत्वपूर्ण होता है ऐसे पदार्थों को निर्मित करना। दोस्तों, यूं तो अमेरिकी अंतरिक्ष एजेंसी नासा भारतीय अंतरिक्ष एजेंसी इसरो के साथ पहले भी कई संयुक्त परियोजनाओं पर काम कर चुकी है। आपको याद होगा कि भारत की बड़ी महत्वाकांक्षी परियोजना चंद्रयान 1 पर दोनों देशों ने मिलकर काफ़ी अच्छे परिणाम दिए थे। सफल चंद्र और मंगल परियोजनाओं के बाद हाल ही में एक और संयुक्त अभियान निसार के रूप में सक्रिय है और इस सिंथेटिक अपर्चर राडार का प्रक्षेपण 2020-21 में संभावित है। हमें पूरा विश्वास है कि ऐसे प्रयासों से दोनों देशों के आपसी रिश्तों में प्रगाढ़ता आएगी और मानव जाति के कल्याण के लिए बड़ा अहम होगा। वैसे मैं आपकी जानकारी के लिए बता दूं कि एंट्रिक्स और नासा के बीच करे किए गए करार के तहत 2015 और 16 के बीच में इसरो 9 अमेरिकी नैनो एवं सूक्ष्म उपग्रहों का प्रक्षेपण करेगा। इस समय हम लगभग 12 मिनट का समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं। जो निष्पादन है बिल्कुल सामान्य अनुमानित पथ अवलोकित पथ के बिल्कुल करीब से गुजरता हुआ। हम इस समय 3661 किलोमीटर की दूरी रेंज प्राप्त कर चुके हैं और ऊंचाई 450 किलोमीटर की।
So we are into the coasting phase. As I was mentioning to you, if you can see on the left side of your screen, the bottom curve, which is the altitude profile, the vehicle is continuously climbing the altitude, and as there is no thrust being added by the upper stage, you can see the velocity has been gradually coming down because basically the kinetic energy and potential energy has been being shared. And at 1017 seconds, we will have the ignition of the PS4 stage, which will burn for the next 300 seconds before placing the ASTROSAT and the six customer satellites into an orbit of around 650 kilometers. So velocity right now is 6.9. kilometer per second, another 200 seconds before we have the ignition of the upper stage, the plot of the ground trace. The red curve, what is shown in the graph, is the pre-flight condition as per our pre-launch calculations, and the green one, which is the telemetry being received from the upper stage of the rocket, is being brought in on the pre-flight. So very close match with the pre-flight and the actual flight conditions. Just a quick update on the, I think Alok has already briefed you a lot, and we had a documentary on the ASTROSAT. A little update on the customer satellites. As I was mentioned, we have six minutes. Customer satellites, Lapan A2, which is a microsatellite weighing 76 kilograms, belonging to National Institute of Aeronautics and Space, Lapan, Indonesia. This satellite is primarily meant for providing maritime surveillance using automatic identification, AIS systems. Then we have the NLS-14, which is an ALO satellite built by Space Flight Laboratory, University of Toronto. We had several satellites from this university. And this satellite is meant for exact Earth of Canada. And this, again, is a maritime monitoring nanosatellite. The remaining four nanosatellites, which is called as LEMUR, is a nanosatellite belonging to Spire Global from San Francisco, USA. And this LEMUR satellites are non-visual remote sensing satellites focusing primarily on global maritime intelligence through vessel tracking via the AIS again, and also they have a payload called GPS radio occultation technology. So 900 seconds into the flight and 6.84 kilometer velocity. Another
ji ha ye videshi jo hamare customers hain इस समय वो आप अपने स्क्रीन पर देख पा रहे हो, यही वो विदेशी वैज्ञानिक हैं जिनके प्रयास 6 उपग्रहों के साथ हमारे इस प्रमोचन यान में।
सो अनदर 100 सेकेंड्स बिफोर द PS4 गेट्स इग्नाइटेड। श्री एस किरण कुमार, चेयरमैन ऑफ इसरो, सेक्रेटरी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्पेस, Mr. Kunnikrishnan, who is presently the director of Satish Dhawan Space Center, and Dr. Shivan, who is the director of Vikram Swarayoga Space Center. So all eyes closely on the PS4 ignition. Another 50 seconds.
Plus 16 minutes,
16 मिनट का समय व्यतीत हो चुका है और हम बहुत ही करीब हैं चतुर्थ चरण के प्रज्वलन प्रारंभ के। दरअसल ये बहुत महत्वपूर्ण घड़ी होती है जब पृथक्करण होता है और उसके बाद अगले चरण का प्रज्वलन होता है। इस समय हम लगभग 978 सेकंड व्यतीत कर चुके हैं। बड़ा सुखद अनुभव होता है जब सभी उपग्रह
सीएनसी पीओडी कंफर्म्स रिएक्टर रेंज डेटा।
सो 995 सेकंड्स।
जी हाँ, मैं बता रहा था कि सभी उपग्रह एक ही तरह के पैरामीटर चाहते हैं। इस समय सारे उपग्रह लगभग 650 किलोमीटर की ऊंचाई चाहते हुए और वेलासिटी लगभग 7.5 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड की, लेकिन धीरे धीरे इनके समय जब ये अलग अलग होंगे, जो 6 उपग्रह हैं जैसा आपने बताया, बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण चतुर्थ चरण प्रज्वलित।
सो PS4 has been successfully ignited at 1014 seconds.
बिल्कुल सामान्य निष्पादन 1014.3 सेकंड पर चतुर्थ चरण प्रज्वलित हुआ और उसके बाद अपने पथ पर अग्रसर होता हुआ।
सो व्यू ऑफ द मिशन कंट्रोल सेंटर, आई थिंक ऑल आईज ऑन जस्ट गेटिंग अ कंफर्मेशन ऑन द नॉमिनल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ PS4 स्टेज। The PS4 stage will burn for almost 300 seconds. As I mentioned to you, this is a stage with having 1600 kilograms of propellant. We'll have a burn time of almost 300 seconds. So you can see the velocity is gradually increasing now, 6.77 kilometer per second.
Fourth stage performance normal.
So PS4 stage performance is normal.
Plus 18 minutes.
18 minutes into the flight.
जी हाँ, जैसा मैं आपको बता रहा था कि इस चतुर्थ चरण के प्रज्वलन के बाद पृथक्करण शुरू होगा। एस्ट्रोसैट जो हमारा पहला वेधशाला है हमारी, उसके बाद लापान A2, फिर NLS 14, 14, लेमूर 1, 2, 3 और 4। इनका जो पृथक्करण है वो लगभग 1353 सेकंड से 1533 सेकंड के बीच होगा, जहाँ पे अलग अलग समय में, जहाँ पे हम करीब करीब उन्हें सबको 650 किलोमीटर की ऊंचाई पे अलग करेंगे, जब उनका मान वेग मान लगभग 7.53531 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड के आसपास होगा। एक्चुअली जो पृथक्करण घटनाएं हैं ये बहुत महत्वपूर्ण होती हैं। जैसा मैं आपको बता रहा था, बहुचरण आधारित यान के विभिन्न चरणों को उनके उपयोग हो जाने के बाद मुख्य यान से अलग कर दिया जाता है। इस पृथक्करण के लिए आवश्यक है कि वो सुरक्षित और संघट मुक्त हों। ये पृथक्करण घटनाएं अभियान के लिए बेहद नाजुक होती हैं, इसलिए इनकी अभिकल्पना पर सबसे ज्यादा ध्यान देकर इन्हें साफ सुथरा, संतुलित और सख्त बनाया जाता है। PSLV-C30 में ऐसी अनेक पृथक्करण घटनाएं हैं। अभीष्ट कक्षा में पहुंचने के बाद एस्ट्रोसैट, लापान A2, NLS-14, लेमूर 1, 2, 3 और 4 उपग्रह यान के अंतिम चतुर्थ करण से अलग हो जाएंगे। ये पृथक्करण प्रमोचन के लगभग 1353 से 1533 सेकंड के बीच होंगे। हम इस समय 1165 सेकंड का समय व्यतीत कर चुके हैं और हम जो वेग मान प्राप्त कर चुके हैं वो लगभग 6.83 किलोमीटर प्रति सेकंड का, और चतुर्थ चरण का जो निष्पादन है, परफॉर्मेंस है, बिल्कुल सामान्य।
सो PS4 स्टेज परफॉर्मेंस नॉमिनल। अनदर 150 सेकंड्स, आई वुड से मे बी अराउंड 200 सेकंड्स, 1315 सेकंड्स इज अ नॉमिनल time at which the PS4 stage will cut off and it will deliver the velocity of 7.5 kilometers per second. So we are very close to 7 kilometer per second velocity. As Alok was mentioning, after the upper stage gets cut off, we have the separation first of the AstroSat mission, AstroSat satellite, followed by separation of Lapan A2, NLS-14 and then the 4 Lemur satellites. As I was mentioning, we have almost 7 satellites in this mission, and handling the separation dynamics for such a mission is a very complex activity, where after every satellite separation, complex maneuvers are performed to ensure that the satellites are spaced much away from each other so that in the long term they don't have any collision. So 1237 seconds into the flight, very close to 7 kilometer per second, another 500 meter per second velocity.
निदेशक डॉक्टर आनंद रॉय, राधाकृष्ण जी, मैं एक बात जानना चाह रहा था। हम लगभग 45 सैटेलाइट्स विदेश के लॉन्च कर चुके हैं। इसके बाद लगभग हम 50 उपग्रह
प्लस 21 मिनट्स
राधा कृष्ण जी इससे लगातार जुड़े हुए हैं, मैं उनसे जानना चाहूंगा इस अनुभव के बारे में।
या एक्चुअली अलोक, एज यू आर मेंशनिंग, वी हैव सो फार लॉन्च्ड 45 सैटेलाइट्स फॉर इंटरनेशनल कस्टमर्स व्हिच इंक्लूड्स 19 कंट्रीज, एंड विद द टुडेस लॉन्च द नंबर वुड हैव रीच्ड ऑलमोस्ट 51. And most importantly, this is the first time we are launching a satellite from US. So it's all the more important in terms of the commercial business that is being carried out.
Ji haan.
So maybe another 50 to 60 seconds to go into the flight before the PS4 stage cuts off. 6.98 kilometer per second velocity. And we are seeing on our screen, the orbital velocity has been nearly reached. We are into an orbit of 653 by 574 and with an inclination of 6.19 degrees. I think very close, that is on your screen, 650 by 640.
PS4 engine shut off.
So PS4 cutoff has been issued. And very close to the nominal orbit. So we will just awaiting the separation for the ASTROSAT. So orbit is 650.3 by 650.3 and 6 degree inclination. Very precise mission, in fact.
जी हाँ, वो चार वैज्ञानिक, चार चेहरे जो आप अपने स्क्रीन पर देख पा रहे हैं, शार के डायरेक्टर, इसरो के चेयरमैन, वीएसएससी के डायरेक्टर और एलपीएससी के डायरेक्टर कुन्नी कृष्ण जी, किरण कुमार सर, डॉक्टर सोमनाथ.
ASTROSAT has been separated. ASTROSAT has separated.
पृथक्करण हो चुका है, बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण चरण. स्पेस एप्लीकेशन सेंटर के निदेशक श्री तपन मिश्रा जी.
सो नेक्स्ट सेपरेशन विल बी एनएलएस 14 फॉलोड बाय द फोर लेमूर सैटेलाइट्स फ्रॉम यूएस. तो वेरी प्रिसाइज ऑर्बिट.
23 मिनट्स.
लापान इज सेपरेटेड एंड प्लेस्ड इन द ऑर्बिट.
लापान A2 सेपरेटेड.
जी हाँ, लापान A2 का सेपरेशन की घोषणा आपने सुनी. ये उपग्रह भी पृथक्करण हो गया और अब अगला NLS 14.
या, दिस इज द फर्स्ट कस्टमर सैटेलाइट लापान A2 फॉलोड बाय NLS 14 एंड फोर लेमूर सैटेलाइट्स.
इसके बाद अमेरिकन जो
NLS 14 सेपरेटेड. यस, NLS 14 हैज बीन सेपरेटेड. Now we will have the Lemur, four Lemur satellites getting separated one after the other.
जी हाँ, वो चार लघु उपग्रह जो अब सेपरेट होने की कगार पर बिल्कुल.
Plus 24 minutes.
Lemur one is separated.
Lemur one has been separated.
चौदह सौ बयालीस सेकेंड पे लेमूर वन का पृथक्करण और अब केवल तीन नैनो सैटेलाइट्स अमेरिका के अलग होने के लिए शेष. रेंज ऑपरेशन डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर वरा प्रसाद, आप चेहरों पे मुस्कुराहट आप बिल्कुल साफ साफ देख पा रहे होंगे. बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण क्षण होता है.
लेमूर टू हैज बीन सेपरेटेड. So from Lemur 1 to Lemur 2, next 30 seconds, we have the separation of Lemur 2. Another two more satellites, with that the mission will be on.
एक इत्मीनान की सांस भारतीय वैज्ञानिक अभियंता ले पाएंगे जब दो और नैनो सैटेलाइट्स अलग हो जाएंगे, लेमूर 3 और लेमूर 4. पहला अवसर जब अमेरिका के लिए ये भारत का प्रयास होगा और आने वाले दिनों. जी हाँ,
लेमूर 3 हैज बीन सेपरेटेड सक्सेसफुली. देयर इज वन मोर सैटेलाइट टू गो बिफोर वी हैव द एंड ऑफ मिशन. सो आउट ऑफ सिक्स कस्टमर सैटेलाइट्स वी हैव 5 सैटेलाइट्स ऑलरेडी इन ऑर्बिट एंड दिस इज अ सक्सेसफुल सेपरेशन ऑफ द लेमूर 4 सैटेलाइट एज वन.
ये था समापन एक तरह से.
कांग्रेचुलेशंस टू अनलॉक.
सभी लोगों का उम्मीद पूरी होती है. इस सारे प्रसारण तक आप हमारे साथ बने रहे, इसके लिए हम आपके आभारी हैं.
PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT मिशन इज अकम्प्लिश्ड इन फुल.
इस समय अभियान नियंत्रण कक्ष के अंदर बिखरा उत्साह, चारों तरफ खुशी की लहरें, हम आपको सीधे वहीं लिए चलते हैं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, नमस्कार, शुभ दिन, जय हिंद।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। ऑल द सैटेलाइट्स हैव बीन सक्सेसफुली सेपरेटेड एंड नाउ वी मूव ऑन टू द मिशन कंट्रोल सेंटर वेयर श्री एस किरण कुमार, चेयरमैन इसरो सेक्रेटरी डिपार्टमेंट स्पेस, विल एड्रेस द इसरो एंड द इंडियन कम्युनिटी। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
Good morning to all of you. Today is one of the very eventful days because PSLV, our workhorse, has put in an astronomy mission which is being looked at not only within the country but globally for bringing in new information to the scientific community. I congratulate the entire ISRO team for the wonderful job they have done. Now I would request Kunni Krishnan, director of this center, to give us some details.
The most trusted vehicle of ISRO has shouldered this time also and has come out in flying colors. It was nation's responsibility. PSLV success spree is continuing, and today PSLV has completed its 30th consecutive successful mission with the injection of ASTROSAT and six more satellites into a very precise orbit. All these successes have come not by chance, all of us know. ISRO has been treating each and every mission as the first mission, giving its 100% on quality through the disciplined and dedicated efforts by the entire ISRO community. ASTROSAT is the hard-earned gift of ISRO to the world in the area of astronomy. It's the culmination of well-focused and synchronized efforts of the different scientific and technological institutions in the country. The stringent environmental conditions required for the sophisticated payload instruments in the ASTROSAT have called for very tight environmental and contamination control at all the facilities in the satellite centers and also at Sriharikota during the assembly, testing, and during the integration of the satellite with the launch vehicle. With the launch of six auxiliary satellites along with ASTROSAT today, the total number of commercial foreign satellites launched by PSLV has become 51, crossing the half century mark in the commercial satellites launched by PSLV. We are getting ready with another dedicated commercial mission with PSLV-C29 with six satellites from Singapore. All of us must be happy, all of us must be proud to see that PSLV has established its prominent presence in the international space market. I would like to congratulate the entire ISRO community who have toiled hard for accomplishing three consecutive monthly missions from Sriharikota, which have all been huge successes. I am sure that the success spell of ISRO will continue and make our country proud. Today, India has taken a giant technological leap and joined hands with the world to see that the mysteries of the universe is unraveled. First of all, I must congratulate the whole team here, and let's all hope that the scientific community, specifically the astro scientific community in India and all over the world, will benefit immensely from our newly launched multi-wavelength astronomical observatory in space. Thank you.
Project director Jay Kumar. Good morning. It is
simply excellent and exciting. Really, everything went down well with the PSLV-C30 ASTROSAT mission. And as it was pointed out, we have reached the 30th success of PSLV continuously. And in fact, our team in ISRO, we affectionately call the ISRO team has done it again. It's a 100% mission accomplishment. And we had the opportunity to carry the first astronomical satellite and put it in orbit, and along with that, 6 commercial satellites, and another importance is 4 numbers are from US. So this is the maiden opportunity given to us to carry US satellites also. And it's in all respect, it's a very important and prestigious mission for us. And I'm sure every one of the team ISRO should feel proud of contributing as a partner of this prestigious mission of ISRO. And now, in fact, we have employed the PSLV XL, that's the extended version of PSLV for this mission. And I would say this performance of the vehicle, all the propulsion stages and all systems have performed excellently well, and the satellites have been put in precisely into the orbit. You would have seen the orbit is very close to the requirement of 650 kilometer and 6 degree inclination. And the success of this is, in fact, really we don't leave any even minor issues on or unaddressed. We have an excellent review system, and all have been attended and very thoroughly. And I also would like to point out here, we are greatly depending on the Indian industries. In fact, they are helping us a lot by providing us a very quality products. That is the success you are seeing today. Let me take this opportunity to acknowledge and compliment each and every one of the team ISRO, the industries, the seniors who have been giving guidance to us and helping us in resolving all our issues day-to-day basis. And let me also wish good luck to the satellite team for the early commissioning of the satellites. Thank you.
We now have Dr. Sharma, the project director of the ASTROSAT.
Thank you, sir. Good morning to you all. It's indeed a memorable day and a proud moment for all of us. We congratulate and thank PSLV team on successfully placing ASTROSAT in defined orbit. The orbit is come as 644 by 651 with precise inclination 6.002. And it's very good orbit. So, as you know that ASTROSAT is built with a lot of years of hard work, dedication, and determination by several teams. And I saw payload professors really working with passion and extreme care and realizing the payloads. So ASTROSAT team is today delighted and feel excited on the successful injection of satellite into the orbit and start feeling that already our hard work is paying off. I'm personally honored to be here as project director, and I thank senior management for providing me this opportunity. Before I end, I shall say that the satellite is doing fine post-separation, and the information from Satellite Control Center is that the intended important auto operations that to happen after separation, like solar panel deployment and SSM payload hold-on mechanism release, all this happened and went very well. There is nothing else. In coming days, payloads will be commissioned one by one, starting from the 8th day. And then we'll look forward for a good science, as director told. And then we look for a good payloads, data, and the science community to get some benefit out of that. Thank you very much.
Now request Director VSSC to say a few words.
Success is the only way of PSLV missions. This sweet success is a result of systematic realization of the vehicle systems, in-depth analysis of the design, and a very meticulous review system and very hard quality system in place. This particular mission have a special characteristics that we could compress the realization of the system is very fast, thanks to industries as well as our ISRO centers to make it very fast, also to realize and the plan the mission in the very shortest time. Let me congratulate the entire team across the ISRO centers for their wonderful work, and you are having a lot of work ahead to do a further job. Thank you very much.
Director LPSC.
There is nothing to speak about PSLV. We have the success again. And this success has come out of dedicated efforts of all of you spread across the centers of ISRO and our partners in industry. From LPSC, I can tell you that the industrial contribution has been increasing steadily. Almost 70% of the control components that has flown in this last mission is from directly from industry. So I have my kudos to them, and we look forward that it will reach almost 100% in the coming missions. The dedicated effort by our team to ensure the stages reach SHAR in very, very fast pace without any compromise on quality and reliability of the systems has again been demonstrated. So let me thank once again all across ISRO centers for both spacecraft and launch vehicle and the mission design teams, and further operations for the spacecraft to become fully operational. And I wish the science community will be benefited greatly from this fantastic mission. And I wish the success of PSLV continue for many more years to come. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Now we have the director of ISRO Satellite Center, which has worked for a long time for this satellite.
Thank you, sir. At the outset, I think it's really, really see a political lunge of PSLV. It looks like somebody writing a script to the tunes. I think that's how it has happened for 60-degree inclination, very, very precisely putting all the satellites together. And that is, PSLV has done its job. It's a baby step for the ASTROSAT, and it is doing well. And as already President told, deployment, the first two deployments took place, and the subsequent 2 months, I think one by one instruments will come through. And this is basically the culmination and hard work of the scientists, engineers, technicians, administrators, and the auxiliary support team, with working together with their hard work and their sacrifice, including their family members. I think that has contributed, the Team India's contribution to the world of science, I think, ASTROSAT. And when I'm telling about ASTROSAT, it will take another 2 months, as I'm telling. And the GSAT-6, which we launched a month back, it's doing well. The unfollowable antenna successfully deployed, and today we are able to anywhere in India, one can communicate with the handheld communication system. Having told the party upon past month, coming months, I think already when the PSLV putting the satellite into the orbit, and we have GSAT-15, a three-tenner, is getting into the spaceport for the possibly another 4 to 5 weeks from here, the launch. And parallelly, I think September 30th, we have the pre-shipment review for the IRNSS-1E, and we have another Panjaratnas, the 5 satellites are in the advanced stage of getting ready, so that every month almost one satellite coming out of the ISRO Satellite Center. I think this is this basically, ISRO is now getting into a new era of what ISRO India wants. I think the requirements to meet that, and people are working, the centers are working, and towards, when we are talking about enthusiastically with the pride this happening, this is because the seniors are given the pedestal. I think this pedestal, it is our our duty to ensure this, we carry forward this, and this continues, so that the new space era of India emerging, and for that I think we have all the reasons to work, and the ASTROSAT is one of such mission. It has given the science community the world of science. For this, I think for people who are enabled for all these things to happen, I would like to once again place my thanks and my team's thanks. Thank you. Thank you very much.
We have Director IPRC.
First of all, let me take this opportunity to congratulate all the agencies who have participated in this grand success. A special thanks also to industries whose untiring efforts helped us to keep the schedules. IPRC Mahendragiri has been a critical center in the development and launch of these launch vehicles.
And every time these schedules became critical, the employees have come forward to support the requirements of the organization. And this time also, they have played a key role in delivering the systems on time. A big thanks to all employees of IPRC Mahindrigiri. Thank you.
We have with us today one of the honorable guests, Minister of State for Science and Technology, Sri Y.S. Chowdhury. I request him to say a few words on this occasion.
Good morning to one and all. It's really a proud moment for every citizen of this country. And I congratulate to entire ISRO team, present and past, who have started these missions. And this is being a 30-year success. And I'm sure that you will be doing many more successful launches. And it's exactly going as per our the present Prime Minister's vision and plan, what all yesterday he has said in the United States. In fact, scientific community is really doing extremely well, and the result is very clear. The relationships what our country is now being harnessed and nourished. That is the reason ISRO could able to launch American satellites here. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Congratulations once again.
We have now Dr. Kasturi Rangan, who actually started this idea of ASTROSAT, to tell us a few words.
Kiran, and all my friends here, and the presence of the Honorable Minister, my mentor, Professor Yashpal, and all the members of the astronomical community who matter in this country, and several seniors who have worked in this ISRO organization over years. It's a great day for all of us to see the success of a mission which we were all waiting, especially not because of the fact that we were people working in the space program, but equally importantly that we have been waiting for a satellite which is one of its class. It's not only of this country, but anywhere in the world. The entire astronomical community across the world is watching this with a lot of interest, because it is for the first time the capability of a system to look at a particular object in the sky in multiple wavelengths has been realized. So I should first congratulate all of you for completing this very important first task, placing the satellite where it should be. So my hearty congratulations to you, Kiran, and the leadership that you give in taking this up into the space and putting it, which I am sure is going to herald a new era in the astronomical research. Having been keeping track of this, even though I had left ISRO later on, I know the amount of challenges that this satellite brought to bear in developing both the systems of the spacecraft itself, that is the spacecraft bus in terms of the control systems, pointing system, pointing accuracy, so the arc minutes, stability, jitter stability of arc seconds, and then ability to maneuver the satellite pointing from one location to another. And so these were some of the examples of the type of challenges that the satellite people had to meet. And of course, it had to be put into an orbit, a low Earth orbit, and also putting it for the first time into a low inclination orbit at 6 degrees inclination. On the other side, the 5 instruments that went into this satellite, they were the result of a tremendous professional capability of our astronomical community spread over the different laboratories in this country, whether it is Tata Institute, we have the director of the Tata Institute here, Indian Institute of Astrophysics, we have the director here, the Indian, the IUCA, the Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics at Pune, and then ISRO Satellite Center, and also the many other institutions which worked with them, not only within India, but abroad too. So it has been one of the most challenging effort that has been put here. No doubt it took us more than a decade to realize it, but if one looks into the complexities of the instruments that have been flown on this, there is no doubt that this is the kind of time that would have been expected, even though we estimated, underestimated the time that will be needed to fly this. But what is unique about this mission is at the time when we conceptualized it and we wanted to fly it, we thought if we don't do it in the 8 to 10 years, it would not become useful because others will overtake us. But so nice to see now that there is no second satellite of this class and it is still very relevant and it's going to produce as and when it is fully operationalized. Of course, I've been discussing with the chairman ISRO of what is his vision beyond this, and he knows that he has got a whole host of astronomers who are very keen to follow this up. He also knows that a more bigger challenges of this type will be always provide an India a preeminence in astronomy. So he told me that he is going to really start something as a second generation AstroSat system and probably go through this in the coming years into more advanced observational capabilities, which will keep India very much in the forefront of the frontiers of astronomy and astrophysics. He also told me that he has got a grandiose plan to bring in universities into the research and development of this particular mission, another major effort. I am sure you will succeed. We have already seen it happening within the very short period you have been the chairman, and we hope you the very best, and through you, the entire ISRO community who are here and elsewhere, I wish you all the very best.
I now request Professor Yashpal to say a few words on this occasion.
Maza aa gaya yaar. You know, whenever I come here and meet my friends in ISRO, old friends in ISRO, I think this is the way to go forward. This is the way to go forward in India, and this is the way to go forward in the world. To be self-reliant, to depend on yourself, to take things from everywhere where they come, but then modulate them and train them and make them different. This has been the character of ISRO right from the beginning. And you see this happening here. And it's coming to a stage where technology and science and thinking, sochna, you know what is sochna? Thinking should come right in front. And this is the organization, this is the setup in the country which will happen, make it happen. So I, it's all right for me to think like this. I may not have very long to contribute. There are many other people who are coming forward, but I think we have discovered it. But let the politicians, let us tell everybody else, this is the way to do it. Not just to shout and claim. And we do it because it's fun. Just as I said right in the beginning, maza aa gaya. You know this phrase, maza aa gaya. I think this is fantastic to really live and be part of it and see that we'll go forward. I'm sure we'll do first-rate science ultimately, the way we have started. And we keep on doing, and we begin to do first-rate science, first-rate technology, first-rate society. I think that is what we have to do, not just technological world, but a first-rate human world. And if we can do that, that is what space is meant for us. That is what it meant by Sarabhai. And I think that's how we started. So I'm delighted that we have gone this full circle almost, and I think there are many circles to be drawn yet, and you'll all draw it. And I give you my best wishes, and maza aa gaya, phir maza aa gaya, phir maza aa gaya.
So with this, we come to the end of today's program, but we have a long way ahead. See, we are now working on making sure by March next year, our complete constellation of IRNSS series completing, and we also have the GSAT-15, which just took off yesterday from India to Kourou for a launch from Ariane. Then we have a commercial satellite, which is going to be launched from our PSLV, and we are also looking at how we can enhance our capacity in the near future to meet all the requirements of communication as well as remote sensing activities. And I take this opportunity once more to thank all the people who have contributed to this mission. Thank you.
Chat.